different. And I thought, if I use no names, if I use no names, then I have to describe what is. So there is no Pakistan, there is no Lahore, there is no Islam, there is none of that in this book. It's just people doing things. And then what starts to come out of it, in a way, it's like, you know, if you're describing an iPhone, the way we talk about an iPhone usually is to say that, you know, this is an iPhone, it has apps, and it lets you do this, it lets you do that, etc. But we're using brand names for the whole thing. If you take away the brand names, you say this is a little small block of machinery that I put to my ear, I can use it to speak to other people and to do X, Y, Z. It becomes a problem. It's a hard thing. You know, taking away the name iPhone reveals a really weird interaction you're having with a machine. And so I thought taking away the name Pakistan and Lahore, etc., etc., would be part of it. That was one part. The other part of it was, I think, you know, there's often this critique out there that people say, oh, you know, you are exploiting, you know, Pakistan, you're writing about Pakistan, etc., etc. And I think it's just nonsense, but part of it is to say, it's a type of censorship. You know, when people get out there and say, why are Pakistani writers writing about this or writing about that, they should write about this, they're exploiting. It's the same nonsense we hear. Why do you believe in this God or no God? Why do you love this man or no, you know, woman, whatever? It's too much should in our society. And so, as a writer, you have two choices. Either you cave in, or you become silent. And you use silence selectively. And so for me, having no names gives me the freedom to say whatever I want. I don't have to be worried, you know, how is this portraying Pakistan? The word Pakistan never appears in the book. How is it portraying our religion? What religion is it? In a way, hopefully you can speak more honestly, because you just tell everybody, look, if you are so attached to these brands of country and religion, whatever else it is, have them. They're yours. Let me just talk about people. And the last thing is, as far as using no names is concerned, you know, and I find it so, I find it so annoying, this whole nonsensical what people should write about, etc. The whole point of art is not to have any of that. You do what you want to do, you know. And in our society, we're so restricted to be held back. So sometimes I think it's better just to, you know, to shut up and to find a different way of saying things. And to be honest, the inspiration for this, you know, this kind of motif comes from our poetry and our tradition, which is to say, if certain things cannot be said, find a different vocabulary for it. Talk about another. Don't talk about perhaps what you might otherwise talk about. So then the last thing about the no names thing is, you know, so often we think, if you're going to write about the world, you know, an American novel, a novel set in America, tells us what the world is today. You know, if you want to describe the great urban migration of billions of poor people to cities, which is the transforming planet Earth right now, what cities do you pick? You know, what are the archetypal cities? It's London, it's New York, it's Tokyo, whatever. Why can't it be Lahore? You know, I think that. I don't believe in really national identification and religious identification. None of it. Those are things that one imagines. You know, one believes. But a city is real. It exists. You know, I am a boy. And so I wanted to also, by taking away names, write a novel that wasn't, oh, look at Pakistan. What an interesting, weird place. That's in your headlines. Instead, it was to say, this is humanity. You can find the world here. You know, you can find the universe and the human being, and you can find humanity this place. And so it was an attempt to escape from this sort of exotic pigeonhole and take on, you know, humanity as a whole.